Greetings. My name is Olaye Tare. I'm from Barmatu Kingdom. I'm the General Secretary of Combat. For sake of members of the public, Combat is a graduate pressure group that is registered with Corporate Affairs Commission, CAC. The membership of Combat is drawn from both Igbema and Barmatu Kingdom. That's why the formation of the word Combat is taken from the first letter of each of the major oil producing community in both kingdoms. The K stands for Kokodiagbene. The O stands for Gudugudu. The M stands for Makaraba. The B stands for Binikoku. The O stands for Opuama. And the T, Shekelewu. We are here today to address the victimization of our son, Comrade Timi Okereka, by Chevron Nigeria Limited. Victimization is defined as the action of singly someone's act for cruel or unjust treatment. And this is exactly what Chevron Nigeria Limited has done to our son, Comrade Timi Okereka, who is an indigene of Binikoku community, an oil-rich community playing host to Chevron Abitibi Flow Station in Escravos. Comrade Timi Okereka was employed in the year 2000 as a senior staff in CNL alongside three other Igbema and Barmatu Kingdom indigenes as a result of combat struggle. But his employment was stolen from him in January 2011 by CNL for no just cause. And we have been patient with CNL to do the needful in this time, but to no avail. There's come a time when the victimized and the oppressed must rise up to the oppressor, and that time is now. It will be realized or recalled in June 2010, CNL sponsor Comrade Timi Okereka and other branch executive council members of Pengasin to London and industrial relation training. Pengasin requested for CNL to book everyone in the same hotel as management, but CNL refused, claiming that CNL does not make accommodation arrangements for employees in Europe anymore and gave them money to book their own accommodation. Comrade Timi Okereka exhausted the whole money that was given to him and even added his own personal money to supplement the inadequate allowance given to them for the trip and submitted receipts to that effect. But in January 2011, 7 months after the trip, CNL Chevron Nigeria Limited, without a verbal written or query, invited Comrade Timi Okereka and others for an interview, yet they were excused, yet they accused of breaching company policy by submitting incorrect invoice of the accommodation money for the trip. But Comrade Timi Okereka maintained his innocence. And his employment was terminated a week later, but CNL pardoned those that were caught red-handed and agreed breaching company policy. In July 2011, Pegasin concluded its investigation on the alleged breach of company policy by Comrade Timi Okereka and exonerated Comrade Timi Okereka of any wrongdoing and demanded its reinstatement. But CNL refused, stating that he was terminated for breaching company policy. In 2012, Combat resisted the termination of Comrade Timi Okereka employment, and CNL invited Combat, EGCDF, Kings, and Chiefs of Igbema and Barmatu Kingdom, including Comrade Timi Okereka father, Chief Dr. Wellington O. Okereka, CON, the Bolowe of Barmatu Kingdom, to a meeting in Lagos to resolve these and other issues at the meeting. CNL promised to reinstate Comrade Timi Okereka within 14 days but later reneged on the promise. In 2012, Comrade Timi Okrika and two other petitions the House of Representatives of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, CNL, and the petitioner were invited for an investigative public hearing by the House Committee on Public Petition. And after concluding its investigations, the report urging the reinstatement of Comrade Timi Okrika was unanimously adopted by the House. And in 2013, a letter was sent to CNL by the National Assembly during the reinstatement of Comrade Timi Okrika. But CNL ignored the letter and took no action. In 2014, the House Committee on Legislative Compliance invited CNL severally to explain why it was refused to comply with the National Assembly resolution on the reinstatement of Comrade Timi Okrika. And after several meetings, CNL agreed to comply and reinstate Comrade Timi Okrika, but CNL later reneged on its promise, stating that it cannot resign its earlier position because it was terminated for breaching company policy. In 2015, Comrade Timi Okrika petitioned the Federal Ministry of Labour and Productivity and the Honorable Minister of Labour, as at then, Chief Emeka Ngozi Wogu, invited CNL, Pengasin, and Comrade Timi Okrika for interview. And after concluding its investigation, the Federal Ministry of Labour adopted the position of the National Assembly and recommended the reinstatement of Comrade Timi Okrika. But CNL again refused, stating that he was terminated for breaching company policy. In 2017, Comrade Timi Okrika filed a suit with suit number NICN/LA/35/2017 on its wrongful termination at the National Industrial Court, NIC, sitting in Lagos. But during the hearing, CNL, through its counsel, rather than prove its case of breach of company policy against Comrade Timi Okrika, revised its earlier statement and argued that Comrade Timi Okrika was not terminated for any breach of company policy, but because his service was no longer needed. In February 2020, the NIC delivered its judgment dismissing the case on the ground that CNL claimed that Comrade Timi Okrika was not terminated for any breach of company policy, but that his service was no longer required. It is clear that CNL, Chevron Nigeria Limited, revised itself in court because it was unable to prove that Comrade Timi Okrika committed any crime or breach company policy. Therefore, the opposite question one could ask is, one, if Comrade Timi Okrika has been reinstated back to employment after CNL admitted in court that he was not terminated for any crime or breach of company policy, which was the reason CNL earlier gave to Benicru community to combat to EGCDF, Pengasin, National Assembly, Federal Ministry of Labour and Productivity, and the whole world for Comrade Timi Okrika's termination and refusal to reinstate him. Secondly, if CNL also terminates the employment contract of the three Igbema and Bramatu indigenes employed with Comrade Timi Okrika on the same day, under the same circumstance, with combat struggle. If CNL also terminates the employment contract of the union officials whom were caught red-handed and admitted to breach of company policy after the fact. Four, if CNL was winding down its operation in a BTA flow station, Benicru community in particular, and Nigeria in general, and leaving Nigeria thereby making Comrade Timi Okrika service no longer required. If Comrade Timi Okrika job no longer existed and Chevron could not find alternative job for him as a senior staff of the company, thereby making his service no longer required. If the answer to the above questions are in the negative, did Chevron's action stroke inaction not occasion discrimination, victimization, and miscarriage of justice on Comrade Timi Okrika and Benikuku community? Furthermore, of all the union executives terminated by CNL, an alleged breach of company policy as a result of their trip to the United Kingdom, only Comrade Timi Okrika was exonerated of any wrongdoing and recommended for reinstatement by Pengasin. The National Assembly and the Federal Ministry of Labor, yet CNL still refused to reinstate him. What have Comrade Timi Okrika done to Chevron that Chevron will be so cruel to him? Why is Chevron afraid of Comrade Timi Okrika? Is it because of the breach of PRO? Is the branch PRO of Pengasin, Chevron branch? He fought for the implementation of the local content and improved welfare and working conditions for Nigerian workers. And the end casualization of Nigerian workers. Or is it a crime to fight for the people? This is someone whose father, Chief Dr. W.O. Okrika, CON, the Bolowe of Baramatu Kingdom, almost paid the ultimate price with his life for Chevron when militants in the opposite camp almost killed him when resolving community crisis to create favorable, peaceful environment for Chevron during his two-time consultancy for Chevron, and even saved Chevron chopper from being downed by militants who aborted the operation. When this news reached them that Chief Dr. W.O. Okrika, CON, was on board the chopper, and yet CNN for 10 years now have refused to listen to the plea from Baramatu community. CNN has refused to listen to the plea of Combat. They refused to listen to the plea of EGCDF, of chiefs and kings of both kingdoms. They refused to listen to the plea of Pengasin. The National Assembly and the Federal Ministry of Labor of this great country and the reinstatement of his son, Comrade Timi Okrika. It is a point to note that the National Assembly Joint Section is the highest lawmaking body of this country, yet Chevron could ignore them. For the management of Chevron Nigeria Limited to disregard a valid order on the reinstatement of Comrade Timi Okrika from the National Assembly and the Federal Ministry of Labor that controls 60% stake of the joint venture operations contract with CNL, controlling 40%. CNL controlling 40% stake and even committed perjury in our court, speaks volume of CNL's integrity and reputation. And that shows Chevron is no respecter of our institution, and that should be unacceptable by all Nigerians. The fight for the reinstatement of Comrade Timi Okrika is not about him alone, but for all youths of Igbema and Baramatu Kingdom. They too can be employed by CNL today and terminated today for no just cause if we allow this bad precedent to stand. Therefore, we will not rest, we will not tire, we will not waver, we will not surrender, we will not back down, and we will never give up until justice is done and Comrade Timi Okrika is reinstated back to employment. On March 22nd, last month, 2021. The president and the secretary of Combat handed the management of Chevron Nigeria Limited a final warning letter stating that unless we hear from them by April 5th, 2021, that they were to declare at once to withdraw their termination letter given to Comrade Timi Okereke and restate him back to employment as directed by the National Assembly and the Federal Ministry of Labour, a state of war will exist between us. We have to tell you now that no such undertaking have been received and that consequently, this body is at war with CNL and we mobilize to disrupt CNL operation and shut down a BTA flow station, others and other CNL interests in our kingdom. This is not a threat, but it is a promise. And we want the good people of Igbema and Baramatu, especially the graduates, the respected people of Igbema and Baramatu community, to realize that if Timi Okereke happens to be from the north, this injustice would not have happened to him. If Timi Okereke happens to be from the east, from the west, the reverse will be the case. I'm urging every good people of Igbema and Baramatu. It's a saying that if the good people refuse to do something, evil will prevail. Collectively, we are going to fight this fight. A date will not be given. The flow station in Abidjan will be shut down. And CNN will realize that injustice is no longer part of us. We can never accommodate injustice. This is a warning to Chevron. God bless the good people of Baramatu Kingdom. God bless the good people of Igbema. God bless the good people of Combat. Thank you.